It told Homeland Security that it could no longer refer to America as a nation of immigrants. Our president has failed to build a wall on the Mexican border, so he's trying to build a wall around American history, while only the great-grandchildren of slaves and proud members of our tribes can do that, Mr. President. Not the grandson and the husband and the son-in-law of immigrants. You can't rewrite our history. In South Carolina this week, I visited the corner where Sarah Mae Fleming, you guys know who Sarah Mae Fleming is? A 20-year-old African-American housekeeper who in 1954, 2 years before Rosa Parks, boarded a bus to go to work, and she sat in a seat to rest her weary feet. The bus driver took her, punched her in the stomach, and threw her off that bus. 2 years before Rosa Parks, have respect for the American history here for a second. 2 years before Rosa Parks, Sarah Mae didn't back down. She rose up. She sued the bus company and she won. And that decision was cited when Rosa Parks, 2 years later, moved this nation forward. This is a time not just to mark history, but to make history. And Democrats will make that change. So, we as Democrats are a nation that cares, not a nation that scares. We are a nation that gets it wrong in the world. Are we going to be a nation that gets it wrong by tweeting and retreating? Or are we going to be a nation that gets it strong by leading and succeeding? Tell me with whom you walk, and I will tell you who you are. Well, the White House walks with Flynn and Papadopoulos and Manafort and Gates. The White House walks with Rohrabacher. And you know, I've been wanting to say this for a long time. I think we should lock them up. Who do we walk with? Fellow Democrats, we walk with our firefighters who, in the face of a climate change denier, are putting their lives on the line. We walk with police officers and law enforcement heroes who are derided and defunded by this president. We walk with teachers who face a White House that wants to pay for bullets in the classroom, but not books in the classroom. We walk with American heroes like Sarah Mae Fleming and Rosa Parks. We walk with living legends like Dolores Huerta and Maria Elena Durazo. We walk with American leaders like Emma Gonzalez and David Hogg and Alfonso Calderon, students who in the midst of their grief are calling BS on Washington and saying, it's time to leave. We walk with the grandchildren of Nisei soldiers and code talkers, engineers who took us to the moon and to Mars, who gave us the internet here in California, and who are finding a cure to cancer. We walk with our longshore workers. We walk with those folks who build our skyscrapers and unload our Christmas presents. So here, in conclusion, my friends and fellow Democrats, like Sarah Mae Fleming, we're not going to give up. We're going to rise up. We're going to rise up in Santa Clarita and in San Marcos. We're going to rise up in Irvine and in Oceanside. We're going to rise up in Bakersfield and Modesto. We're going to rise up in Fullerton and in Fresno. Rise up to save our health care. Rise up to take back our lives. Rise back to protect our bodies and those that we love. Rise up for a strong future. Rise up for a fair future. Rise up for a bright future. My fellow Democrats, it's time to rise up. Let's go home.